Great. So my project was fairly small, but it was really exciting to explore all the options that are here. So my project is about cloud notifier and web support for it, and also a mobile application. So for those who don't know what the cloud portal is, I just shared a screenshot that's of Minion as a service. And here the notifications I'm targeting to are related to devices that are kind of device events and device statistics that will be nice to have whether the user is online or not, like not if they're not always checking on the events, what's going on there or not. So the objective was to create a push notification components that can be reusable in web and mobile application both, to instantly update users about what's going on with the device, is their status offline or online, there's some alarms or not. And for that, the best solution was to have, I thought that it would be nice to experiment, was with a native mobile application. And that could contain very limited functionalities and views related to just particular information that we're trying to see, having authentication so that everyone who downloads that application in their mobile can authenticate to start getting notified. And there should be a link to portal web dashboard, because all of the rest of the steps will be still there. The best part is that it will provide offline experience for static information. And because the authentication will be stored once the user is authenticated, then there won't be any need to continuously log in and see what's going on. And it would be downloadable from Google Play Store or Apple App Store, so easy to access as well. And the other main objective was to definitely experiment with the React Native framework. The best part of this application is framework is that it provides native mobile application experience to users, and it shares code across iOS and Android both. It's kind of hybrid, but not completely, because there are customizations regarding different platforms. Like if you're developing it for Android or iOS, there will surely have some differences. Not exactly the same, but very much the things will be common in those. And the best part is that we can use React components with React Native that we are already using in our current cloud portal. And the React Native is very much famous for its speed and performance as compared to other hybrid frameworks. So the basic flow for web app, so I tried by first implementing it. Actually, that it was a mixture of juggling between the mobile applications and for the flows for the web app. But what the common flow is that client requests application server for getting the tokens, and then when user accepts it, I allow push notifications from cloud services. There will be three components basically: the mobile or client, whether it's portal or application. Other will be our server, and the third part is any cloud service, if we choose to have one, or considering any database or cloud we would like. So these three components will be interacting with each other. The client will be requesting from the server, and the server will be responding with the token. And the cloud service will respond with the token, and if user confirms, all the events will be subscribed and notification will be handled accordingly. These notifications can be unsubscribed as well. So there will be a two-way connection established between server and the cloud service, and that the client will be subscribing to. So what the options I was exploring was, for the front end, there are two types of notifications: local ones that we already have, and the remote notifications that I mean by push notifications, that whether the user is online or offline, server still sends that to us. For web, for front end, there is an npm module called web push that is very much common with Express.js that we don't currently have, but I see that they have a very nice and simplified solution providing with this library. And for React Native, there is React Native push notification. Again, this was great too. And for React simple React web application. There is React web modification NPM that we still don't have in our actual project, but it was really nice to experiment and fairly easy to implement. And other things was quite challenging was the Android and iOS settings and configurations, providing that I was using Android Studio for that and trying out different stuff to make it work and juggling between mobile and web application both. For cloud platforms, there are also many options, including Azure Notification Hub, Google Cloud Messaging API, PubNub, and Firebase Cloud Messaging, and many other more. And same for front-end libraries. There are many. It just depends on what works for us and how feasible it is, how popular it is. So I tried two solutions that was based on cloud, Google Cloud Messaging and Firebase Cloud Messaging, because they were fairly easy to implement and didn't require any server implementations specifically for a prototype. So these were I was working on just a quick snippets for service that was used in React Native for initializing the notifier. Using React Native push notifications that initializes. We have that contains functions for initializing, and if the user accepts that, it would be registered, and on registration there will be notification, and we can just subscribe on. We're using on subscription changes. That's a function that if user accepts the invite for notification, it will be provided. That function will be implemented. Second is the notification handler, that how would we like our to handle our notifications, providing that the application is inactive or is running in the background or is active. So these are the parts that I'm working on. I was working on and targeting Android first because I have simulator and environment already built up and already set up for that. And if the user subscribes, we can just implement our block of code. That's a component that we would like to render, or specifically the kind of information we would like to display. And here comes the all these styling stuff too that we would like to see. We can implement it at this time. So in case the user wants to unsubscribe it and not want it anymore, unsubscribing usually is required in web applications so that user can configure it anytime or unsubscribe it. I forgot to add the slides for what are the trade-offs and what are the challenges if we add push notifications or web or not, because sometimes the browsers have limitations that it will only provide push notifications when Chrome is currently active or its instance is active in the background. Otherwise, it won't. So that's where mobile applications are highly used for those services. So once we have this in and we have it implemented, it would be nice to have some configurable settings for various kinds of notifications in portal dashboard, so that if user doesn't want all kinds of notifications and just want to see some specific ones, they can. And definitely it would be nice to have a general notification service that's in common for mobile and web portal both, and that is customizable. So that was pretty much from me. Thank you so much.
Awesome.
Any comments and any questions related to it?
So just curious, how far did you end up getting with the prototype? Did you end up being able to push a notification, or still playing around with the frameworks and getting familiar?
No, I started with the Firebase one and cloud notification one, but it's still in between and not currently up. It still needs some REST endpoint setup for pushing it up, and should be done in some time if I will focus on it more.
Awesome. Yeah, looks neat.